Alright, let's continue to look. Sewing basket.
Sharp objects. Bit like Claire.
She's a sharp object. Good one.
Karen hated collecting trinkets. She used to say they were just useless dust traps.
I love dolphins, though. Baby picture?
Who knew this sweet little muffin would turn into such a brat? Still super cute, though.
It was inevitable. Wedding picture. I'm trying to look at you. Thank you.
Love the outfits, guys. Man, he looks so different. So young.
A lot younger, yep. So another nightstand. Oh, I think it'd be in the vanity drawer. I do want to look in both. Hopefully they let me look in the other one.
Come on, little key.
In the first one.
Don't be shy.
Oh, the key. I'm going to look at that last. Sleeping pills.
Didn't know Claire had sleep troubles.
Bible, not surprising.
I guess it kind of makes me wonder what would have been different if Dad had taken us to church.
I thought he was done talking about that.
Didn't know Claire had sleep troubles. I guess it kind of makes sense.
Keychain.
How much more Irish can you be?
Alright, that key is obviously it, but I want to look. I'm afraid we'll. I'm afraid.
Okay, Daniel. Think hard.
No, don't think hard. I want to check the vanity. I want to check both. Let me check this as well.
What was she wearing?
Jeez.
I thought he meant think hard to unlock the break open the door.
It was that weird sweater thing.
Dude, you rock.
What are you talking about?
Locked drawer.
Oh.
Maybe the key to Karen's room is inside. Yeah, no. No way I'm searching Claire's underwear.
Under Claire?
Come on.
All
Where
right.
is this cardigan?
So I'm thinking.
No way she. Come on, little
church.
Key. Don't be shy.
So that's the key. I don't know he's talking about a cardigan, but I think this small key would open the desk drawer, and then that key would be in there.
Definitely not the one.
Oh, never mind then.
Way too small.
Oh.
But let's see what it opens.
Oh. Yeah, not for the door, for this. That's what I thought.
Whoa.
I was way ahead.
I'm just looking for a key. Not the crown jewels. Ew.
Her teeth.
Milk teeth?
Wait,
I'm not sure if it's gross or cute.
What do you mean, milk teeth?
But still, no key here.
Milk teeth? I've never heard
Come
that.
Come on, Sean.
Saying.
If you can't find the key, I can still use my power.
Where does the key go to?
This whole house is pretty much a huge washing machine.
So we have the key, right? Do we? No, we used the key. We used the key here. Literally nothing. Just wonder if I missed something. And he was talking about a cardigan. That the key would be in a cardigan?
Clothes. Old stuff. But definitely no hidden key.
Alright, so maybe she took the cardigan off downstairs. What are you doing?
I gotta find a way to open that door.
Also, it's not downstairs.
Or Daniel's gonna keep ranting about it.
So, we can't go down. Looking for a cardigan. Is it on the bed? I can't look at any of this stuff.
Okay, Steven. Where do you hide this key? Yeah, not much to see in here.
Yeah, I don't know. Look again in here.
Shit. These are Christmas presents? Let's not tell Daniel. Or he'd freak.
Okay, I have no idea then.
Daniel, you really think you could open this door without doing too much damage?
Yes! I know I can't.
If we gave him a knowledge of, like, tumblers, locks, and stuff, he could pick the lock with his mind.
We have to get into that room before they come back. We have to get into that room before they come back.
Ask to open.
Fuck. Can't find that stupid key. Just go for it.
Yes.
And don't blow apart the whole house. Really?
He break part of the door.
Wow.
Like the door jam. He did. Look at that.
There's not that much left. Where do you think they put the rest of her stuff?
The dumpster. Maybe they threw it away?
Claire and Steven must have thrown a lot of it away. The rest is probably packed in these boxes.
I want to find out what's going up with their mother, why she left.
It's like she almost never used those.
Teddy bear?
I think I remember that one. Karen showed it to me once. Ulysses. Okay, Daniel. You've seen everything you wanted to see? Claire and Steven will be home soon now.
Just 5 more minutes.
Discuss.
Hey, Daniel. Check this out. His name is Ulysses.
Like, the hero?
I guess.
So cool.
They want to forget anything related to Karen. I can relate.
Tell us. Oh, I want to know.
They looked happy. How could you send all of this to hell?
Just left them? Gotta be something more than her just mysteriously leaving. Must be the circumstances in which she left. Okay, we'll look at this stuff.
These pictures are so...
old?
Random.
Oh.
Yeah. You finally left forever. Coward.
Oh, wow. The Green Choir by Carol Reynolds. Well, that's K. Reynolds. I hear the Green Choir singing in the forest in the ancient gray, wrapping me in their wood spell, their song. The roots like fuses that explode in reverse. When I hide in my heart, hearing that sound, it makes me feel older than the forest, older than you, but younger than the crying river at my feet. If I slid into the soil, would the voices muffle, like my face in the pillow so nobody knows I'm there? I could sneak in through the wormholes, but that would only lead down. So over the treetops, over the river, I feel myself leaving forever. Yeah, fitting, I guess.
Hi.
Is that an amethyst?
Yeah, could be.
She was into New Age bullshit.
That's a rock, man. disposable camera.
Karen liked to take pictures of strangers when we walked down the streets.
Really?
So...
Never been a big fan of hiking. But here I was.
I hope she took
walking my way
care.
Down to Mexico.
Sorry, I can't hear you. I'm too busy talking to myself.
I think I saw a moon eclipse once. Before Daniel was born.
Once.
Karen was still with. I miss my skateboard. And going to the park. With Lila.
My mom loved it so much.
I'm trying to think to myself. What do you say about the glasses I cut him off to?
I think I saw a moon eclipse once. Before Daniel was born.
You're not that far.
Karen was still with us then.
Okay, you keep talking. Letter.
Man, that pen pal sure loved listening to her own voice.
Dear Karen, lesson 3. Thank you so much for your letter. I thought you might have forgot your pen pal. It's so boring out here, and your letters are the best thing ever. You were saying you get very lonely, too, sometimes up there in Beaver Creek, so I'm glad we found each other. It is funny, not, that I have this big family, but I'm so jealous of you for being an only child. You get the whole house to yourself like a queen. I told you before how my stupid brother Keaton is such an immature boy, even though he's the oldest of all my siblings. He thinks he's so cool now just because he has a driver's license. Whatever. Just wait till we can drive, then we can finally visit each other. I hear my dad yelling about something, so I gotta bail before he gets to me. Please write back soon, and I'll write as soon as you do. Your only favorite pen pal, Emma. Lesson 3, I miss you. That's interesting. Old phone.
Guess the no phone rule wasn't such a thing back then.
Well, not for her. She's not on the run from the police.
Well, figures Karen was already looking for an exit.
Exit door to somewhere else. Books.
Read a lot of these in the 10th grade. Yawn.
In this book.
Hope you enjoyed your trips. So you didn't bail on us for nothing.
Wow. Young and free. Easy trips to travel the world before your 30s. Research local secrets, best planning. CD rack?
This playlist is boring as hell.
Wasn't the one in CD in it? That's not a playlist, it's a rack.
I miss my music.
It won't play. Silence.
I think it's not plugged.
Oh. There you go. Wouldn't play anyway. He stopped talking. Did I look in here?
They want to forget anything related to Karen. I can relate.
Yeah. I want to make sure I didn't miss anything. Old board games.
I don't recognize any of these games.
Dice rolling? Alright. Do we see this? Do we see this one?
These letters look pretty recent.
Oh. Open? She's writing them?
Why would Claire lock these up in here?
She doesn't want Steven to see them? Well, she wants to forget about them, but not throw them
out.
Is
that for Mom? Huh? Let me see.
Daniel! Come on.
Let's read it.
What's it say? Read it.
Let's read it.
Seriously, stop.
Come on, man. What's
here.
What's the letter
How
say?
How about this?
I've heard the news about Seattle. Please help my boys if they come to you. What? Why did they hide this from us?
I don't know.
You can reach me at this address.
Ooh.
It's a P.O. box I use sometimes.
Memorize this.
What's a P.O. box?
Well, a cop-out. In this case.
I beg you, please help my sons.
Oh, yeah, right.
Would she help them?
Total bullshit.
What do you mean? She cares about us.
Well, I don't.
Maybe she changed her mind. We could try and contact her.
You don't even know her, okay? Don't get any wrong ideas.
He wants to know her.
We should just stick to our plan. For now.
Can I read it again?
Yeah.
It sounds like you didn't finish
then we
reading
gotta go.
Thank goodness. What happened?
Oh, shit.
Excuse me. What are you both doing in here?
Reading
Except
a letter?
Visibly. Ransacking our house while we're at church?
We wanted some answers.
We were just looking for answers.
Were they really worth breaking my door open?
Claire, please.
Yeah, pretty much.
Calm down.
No, Stephen. They went way out of line here. We specifically told you to stay out of this room.
I have the right to see my mom's room.
This isn't her room anymore. There is nothing to see in here. It's time you learn to respect some rules.
There was some stuff to see in here, like this letter, mom's letter.
Actually, we did find something.
Yeah, we found a new letter from my mom. She said she wants to see us. But...
Well, she didn't say that.
You didn't even tell us.
She's not my daughter anymore, or your mother. She burned all those bridges.
She's still their mother.
One letter doesn't change what she did to me. All of us. She is not welcome back.
Give me... Don't let her have the letter. The P.O. box is on there. Don't blame us for what she did.
Just don't blame us for being curious about her.
But I know her better than anybody.
Or for that.
She hasn't changed. She just feels guilty.
I can't hear that.
Listen, Sean. I know life has been tough on you the past month. Bless your souls. And we put up with a lot of things. But that breaking our door to sneak into the room. Well, that shows you don't respect us.
Oh, God.
We could go to jail just for helping you.
Well, that is true.
This is how you pay us back?
No.
Well, things are just going to change around here if you want to stay.
Man, I think I see why Mom left now. She couldn't put up with your stupid rules anymore.
Oh, so that's what you think. Then let me tell you something.
Huh?
Steven!
Uh-oh. He fell.
Oh, shit!
Oh, that fell
Get
on him.
Get this goddamn thing off me!
He's gonna use his powers and she's
Steven,
gonna see.
No! Hold
you
on,
know
honey,
it's coming.
Get it off!
No! Stop! Oh. My legs!
His mind is stronger. Don't want him to die. Use the power.
Do it, Daniel!
Her head's
now.
Turned.
Do what? What's going on?
Oh, don't look. Don't turn around.
Oh, Lord, what? What are you doing, Daniel?
She's gonna think he's the beast. He is the mark of Satan. Don't let it fall until his legs are all the way out. Okay.
Oh, my baby, Stephen, are you okay?
Now I am. Thanks to Daniel. You were right, Claire.
What?
I should have fixed that couple months ago. I guess my laziness will get me.
I thought he was taking her aside for a second.
What in the name of God was that all about? That's impossible.
That was the number
of the
beast.
Where are you, Daniel?
Claire.
Listen, they saved me, Claire.
He's the devil's disciple.
That's all that matters.
Maybe. It was a miracle. Oh, thank you, Lord.
Okay. So he's an angel. We can go that way, too. The police are here. Yep.
It's sure the sheriff. Are.
We got a bail.
Sean, I didn't. We didn't call them.
I know, Grandma.
Someone called us. We know they've been here. Apparently, someone made a call through your grandson's friends from this house.
Sean, what are we gonna do?
Oops. Go hide in the garage.
No. No. No way. If the police searches the house, that makes the two of you accomplices.
Get your bags and go out the back door. I'll distract him.
Really?
Yes. No. Get the hell out of here.
Wait, are we just leaving or going in the garage?
So sorry for everything. I wish we could have helped you more. I wish you could stay here with us. Watch out for your brother, Sean.
Yes. Be careful.
Watch those windows.
We'll see you as soon as we can, okay?
They're open.
Thanks for helping us. Both of you.
Oh, we love you.
The windows are not covered.
Daniel, wait for me while I go upstairs.
So is she gonna lie and say they were never there? Or that she was there and they left? He can't see the movement in the hallway.
Move your ass, bro. Oh, shit.
Another car.
This way.
I'm confused. Are they supposed to be going to the garage or just leaving? They're leaving. Crap. We're about to flip a police car. Oh no! Flip it! No! Oh my god. He never explained to him he didn't have the power. Man, Chris, is he dead? That's horrible. Maybe he just got knocked out. Knocked unconscious. Concussion, whatever. Crushed ribs, and he'll live. Back on the run again. Didn't have time to grab anything useful, I'm sure.
Why did Chris jump in front of that car, Sean? Why?
He thought he could stop it.
He's okay, Inanno.
Power.
The car barely touched him.
Really?
Oh, God.
I hope he's right.
I wish I told him the truth like you asked me to.
You didn't.
I'm sorry, Sean.
Well, you gave him an impossible...
You shouldn't have laughed.
You gave him an impossible... You gave Daniel... Sean gave Daniel an impossible task. Explain to him that he does not have this power. But don't tell him you have the power. So how do you explain it? You gave him no help in trying to explain this.
I need you and Chris.
It's... It's okay. I know you meant to do good, but don't worry.
You didn't even let me check on him.
Well, the police were coming.
What if he is dead?
He's fine, trust me.
You could see the car slow down before, so Chris will be fine. Trust me.
You promise?
Promise.
But it's slippery in the snow. I'm gonna slow down that fast.
Sean. I'm tired of running away. Why Why does my power always bring trouble?
You don't have to use your power if you don't want to.
Doc, we prefer you not to, most of the time.
But I'm good with it. And I'm the only one who can do these things.
I know, but Daniel, you need to be careful and listen to your brother.
You think we'll see Grandma and Grandpa again?
I don't know.
Ta-da.
We'll see.
Where are we gonna go now?
Mexico.
See Mom?
No way, man. We don't need her, okay?
But she said she wanted to find us.
You gotta write her.
We stick to the plan. We go to Puerto Lobos. That's where we belong. No one will tell us what to do. We can be whoever we want.
You think? I don't know.
Trust me, man.
You can be a superhero?
From now on, we make our own rules. Look, I wanted to wait until then, but we kind of need a little cheer, so. Merry Christmas, Enano.
For me? Thanks, Sean.
There's anything in it? There should be candy.
Hey! Listen!
There's a ride. Come on.
Oh!
Aboard.
Are we getting on a train? Our train hopping days begin? Sweet. Courtesy of a little tip from Cassidy. Well, you gotta jump on it while it's still moving. It's going pretty fast, though. Oh, it's a logging train. Well, it's got coal or something, too. That's going very fast. How would you jump on that? If one of you doesn't make it, you're gonna be separated. Oh, it's slowing down. Insert licensed music here. To be continued. So for their mother, what they have is a P.O. box. So they have a P.O. box. So I mean, even the P.O. box isn't, she doesn't necessarily have to live in that town. They can send her a letter. But saying maybe meet us at this place. Or if they find a place where they could send her a letter and she could write back and say, okay, I'm at this address. But otherwise, it's very difficult. Unless you're going to stake out the P.O. box, and that would be difficult because, you know, a lot of people don't go to their P.O. box every day. Could be once a week for all, you know. Even less than that. Even less frequently. But Daniel definitely wants to meet his mother. Sean definitely does not. So they do not agree there. But I want to find out why she left. There's got to be some kind of reason. Not just for the hell of it. Because she liked to go on trips or something. That's the big mystery, I guess. Well, at least Daniel's no longer sick. They just have to... They're back to square one. Back on the road. He doesn't have any money, so gotta start stealing more food and stuff. I wonder if they have their... I guess they have what's in their backpack. Right? And he did say he straightened things up. So you put all the stuff back in the backpack? Maybe? So they still have their tent and all that stuff? That would be helpful. still remember I bought those hot dogs at the gas station during episode 1 or chapter 1. Never saw them eat them or do anything with them. Okay, the choices. Squeaky chair. You threw a snowball at Daniel, 52%. Did. Oh, 1% threw a snowball at Mushroom. Intervened and scared the cougar off, 55%. This is almost 50-50, to letting Daniel kill the cougar. You prayed together with Claire and Daniel. I was tempted to refuse to pray, but, you know, we're in their house, they're doing a lot for us, let's play along, you know. Claire prayed along and no one prayed. How do you stop Claire from praying? You confessed to Stephen about Daniel's power. He pretended you don't know anything. Wow. We pretended not to know anything. It was straight 50-50 down the board there. You helped with extra chores, 76%. You told Daniel he did the right thing when he saved Chris, 71%. Yes. You used Stephen's laptop to log into your profile. Huh. Most of them didn't do it. I mean, it was kind of 50-50 almost. You used a phone to call Lila. Only 25% did. Wow. So the others, I guess, either overlooked it, or they figured it wasn't worth the risk. You couldn't talk to Lila and lied to her mother. You couldn't talk to Lila and told the truth to her mother. Huh, I wonder how that happens. You didn't gain Chris's trust. Oh, I wonder what we did wrong. Huh. Maybe because we didn't get the monsters right? Those superheroes and villains? I'm not sure. You told Daniel to stop. Oh, excuse me. Lied to Chris about his power. 43%. Well, most people chose to protect Daniel's secret and told him to be careful. You listened to Cassidy's song until the end. 42% did. 58% did not. Just be patient. It wasn't that long. It was like a minute and a half song. You drew a spaceship for Chris. I drew zombies for Chris, 17%. I'm in the minority. I like that. You bought a Christmas present for Daniel. 57%. 33 stole a Christmas present. 10 found several Christmas presents for Daniel. You didn't get involved in Charles's problems, 90%. I didn't want to go confront him about this, so 10% confronted him about it in the car. You let Daniel use his power to help Stephen, and he wasn't hurt, 82%. You chose to pull Stephen out together and injured his leg. Yeah, I figured if we didn't use the power, he'd get hurt more. There's a consequence for everything. The cop chased you, and Chris was hit by a car. How do we stop Chris from being hit by a car? Because here, Chris wasn't hit by a car. So is there one scene where he doesn't run out? Or is there something we can do to stop him that we didn't see? I don't know. The cop didn't chase you and Chris helped you escape. How do we do that? I don't want to see how you do that. Daniel continued to swear, 42%. 58% told him stop. Daniel lost a dice game. 28%. So we did good with the dice game. Sean won. Even trying to cheat once, Sean still won. Daniel didn't kill the cougar. That's the same as before. Daniel killed the cougar. Oh, this is from Daniel's perspective, though? You intervened and scared the cougar off. 55%. Yeah, Daniel didn't kill her. This is redundant. Daniel was not able to bury Mushroom. 55%. What do we do that we can bury him properly? I didn't know. I didn't see anything like that. It just cut to that scene. Daniel agreed to pray. 96%. Daniel didn't want to tidy his room. Huh. I wonder how we convince him to tidy his room. Daniel was an ass to help with the chores? Jeez. Daniel was told to tell the truth, but he continued lying to Chris. Daniel obeyed and told Chris the truth about his power. So maybe if he had done this, 18%, he would not have gotten hit by the car. Huh. That's higher, though. I don't know. Overall, Daniel was repressed from using his power, 58%. Daniel didn't use his power to save Chris from the car. Was that a quick time that I missed? Daniel used his power to save Chris from the car. Well, maybe he would just throw it automatically, but maybe because we kept telling him not to? Well, maybe he was tired from helping the grandpa, Stephen? And he couldn't use his power again so soon? Daniel blamed himself for Chris's accident. 9%. We achieved that. Rare thing. Daniel blamed you. I'm glad that didn't happen. Daniel didn't blame anything. Anyone said Chris was fine. Oh, God. So most people had Chris just being fine. 58%. Nice. Daniel was too upset to enjoy his presence. 43%. That's sad. Oh, well. Maybe it'd be better next Christmas. Experienced and honest, looking for work. What do we got here? Feedback?
So, this is it?
Yeah.
It looks like a nettle field.
It's not snowy.
And it stinks.
Huh?
Yeah. And your stinky feet will cover the smell.
Shut up. They don't.
Come on. I'll show you around.
What you growing over there? Well, I greatly enjoyed this. I think I enjoyed it more than the previous episode. The previous episode kind of dragged. And the Adventures of Captain Spirit was the least of the episodes I've played so far. So next time it'll be episode 3, Wastelands. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.